And now, it's time for another Dice Tower Review with Tom Vasel.
Hey folks, my name is Tom Vasel, and today we're taking a look at Deckscape Test Time. Now this is from DV Giochi. This is their version of the escape room game. This is just a deck of cards, and I'm not going to be spoiling it in this review. I might, in a future week, go through and talk about it spoiler-wise, and so if you've played it, you're like, oh, I want to go watch that so I can see what you thought of the different puzzles. I'll probably do that. But this here is a reusable one. Because it's a deck of cards comes in order, so if I'm done with it, I can just shuffle the deck of cards and give it to you, and you are going to play through this deck of cards. You'll see here, it tells you, warns you at the beginning not to flip through all the cards, and it will tell you on card two, I'm not spoiling anything, it will just tell you, you got to solve a story. And then after that, it starts going through the story and explaining it to you. And you'll get to things. Again, not a spoiler, but here's a thing, for example, a green curtain, and then you have to figure out what to do with it. In this case, the green curtain is pretty simple here, but you need to know other things going on. But there's different puzzles. And then you will use maybe objects. You'll get an object. It'll say, keep this object, and you might need to use that. So what the game does is it will present you with a picture. So maybe, for example, there's a picture of cake. There's not. But let's say there's a picture of cake on the table, and then we'll say, what do you do with this cake? And you might say, eat it, and flip the card. Now, if eat it is the correct answer, it will say, good, go to the next card. Or it will say, incorrect, put an X on a piece of paper. You mark down every mistake you make because that gives you your score at the end of the game. And then you go on to the next one. So you're not going to say what you're going to do until you're sure. Now, that's a pretty simple thing. Usually, there's like some sort of puzzle, and you're like, oh, the answer is 47. Or, oh, you put the yellow key in the green slot, you know. And then you just say what you're going to do, flip the card, and find out. Now, sometimes it will say, hey, if you don't even have this item, you can't do this card yet. Because the way the game is set up, you can diverge, and there might be different piles of cards to go through. So you're going to get to the card and say, oh, what should we do? Now, this game does come with a clue card. And on the back of the clue card, it shows all the different numbers. There's actually two clue cards. And then it has the writing in reverse on them. So if you really want a clue, you can kind of sit there and read it backward. And you're like, oh, that's a clue on how to go through the card. And the number of clues and hints you use will also affect your score at the end. The difficulty of this game is not that tremendous. It's not an extremely difficult game. I played it through, and then I also went through it with my family where I kind of just moderate it. And both me and Jason went through it together, and we whooped on it, but we still made a few mistakes that were things like, oh, I can't believe we didn't think of that. And my family went through, and they made different mistakes and went through. But we both went through, and it has kind of a choose-your-own story. The story in this one is pretty strong. You're you can see here, it's test time here. Dr. Time wants to put your skills to test. You're coming in, he's like, I'm going to be testing your skills. But there's some interesting things that happen along the way, and I thought it was a pretty good story. This one felt pretty close to an escape room where you're not actually physically doing something, but you might say, do this to that, and then you flip the card over, and you're like, yeah, I knew that was what to do, or, oh, I didn't even think of this. And it's also not destructible, too, so that's going to appeal to some people, because once you're done with it, you can give it to somebody else, and they can go through it. I really enjoyed this. I wasn't expecting, I was like, is this like a third one compared to the escape and exit and unlock games? No, this one's right up there with them. It's not as difficult, per se, but the story and the entertainment value I got from it was pretty high. So, highly recommend it from me, Deckscape. Dice Tower Judgment, excellent!
Thanks so much for watching the Dice Tower videos. Find more great videos and reviews, as well as our top-rated audio podcast at Dicetower.com. You can also find other great shows at Dicetowernetwork.com. I'm Eric Summerer, and you've been watching the Dice Tower. The Dice Tower is sponsored by Cool Stuff, Inc., where you can find great games for great prices. Cool stuff in stock. Check them out at CoolStuffInc.com.
Shut the door!